So what's the true price of the stimulus package? All three stimulus packages. Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcat channel. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. What's the price of $6 trillion in stimulus? What is the true price? Well, somebody actually did the numbers, and it turns out with the $6 trillion, with a T, that the government spent on stimulus, they could have sent out checks to every single taxpayer for $41,000, over $41,000, or for every American, it could have been $18,000. For every single American, $18,000. That's what they could have done with the stimulus. But obviously, most of us pretty much got $3,600. And the significance of that is that we're gonna have to pay for everything, for the entire amount, the $18,000 or per person, or the $6 trillion in general. We have to pay for all that. So even though you're only getting a check, you're only seeing $3,600 if you exclude the unemployment. If you get unemployment, then you probably got more than that. Even though you're pretty much only getting like $3,600 because of all these stimulus packages, you're still gonna be expected to pay the $18,000 per person. We're responsible for paying for all of that, especially if you're a taxpayer. So that's the reality of the situation right there. COVID, there's a story in Indianapolis. This guy, he actually shot and killed four people over a stimulus check. Four people in Indianapolis. Black male, I think he's 25 years old. Guy actually shot and killed four people. Like, they're pretty much all family members. One of them was a seven-year-old. Shot and killed them all over a stimulus check. Apparently, he tried to get the mother of his child, to give him some stimulus money. And she said he didn't have a job or anything, so he didn't even deserve it. So she said no. Her brother stuck up for her. Her brother ended up pushing the guy. They got into an altercation. The guy pulled out a gun. He actually shot and killed her brother, and two other people, including a seven-year-old child, over a stimulus check, okay? He shot somebody else, her sister, and she got away, and she eventually told the police what happened. I wonder why it's so easy for so many people in the black community to shoot other people. Why is it so easy for us to kill other people? Because when we look at the statistics, we're responsible for, we got a lot of homicides, and we're disproportionately killing one another. We're responsible for a much higher level of homicides than any other group. And I think sometimes a lot of that has to do with the dysfunction that's created by absent fathers, a lack of fathers really raising their kids. A lot of these guys grow up and they don't really have the tools they would normally get from a man. From a father, a positive father role model. A man pretty much educating us to not be so emotional, just develop good habits. And I think a lot of us, we end up growing up having a lot of anger towards black males because we didn't have a good relationship with our fathers. We felt abandoned by our fathers. And a lot of us, you know, a lot of times we see other black males is like we're taking our anger out on the father that wasn't really there for us. So it's a frustrating thing, but it's not just black males. A 21-year-old in Georgia shot up massage parlors, about two of them. I think he ended up killing eight people. Six of them were Asian American females. So at one point, authorities thought that it may have been racially motivated, but then it turns out he told the police that it wasn't racially motivated. I think he had an addiction to various videos or whatever. He came from a religious family. I don't know what that had. They just said it in articles, and it's hard to really trust what people put in, what the media puts in articles and whatever. But anyway, they described him as being a nerdy guy. We've seen this pattern before. I don't know how he was brought up, but what's going on with young men? And this guy was a white male, so it's not just black males. It's just, what's going on with young men in this country, man? Is it a lack of good fathers? I mean, what's going on? But anyway, speaking of fathers, Kirk Franklin was caught on tape cussing his son out, apparently getting angry because his son apparently disrespected him. His son put that audio out there for the public to hear. And of course, Kirk Franklin is a gospel singer. He's a wonderful singer. I love his work. I like that song, Smile. I've been listening to him since Stump. That one song, Stump, awesome. Look, I'm not even a religious person, but I love his music. I love the positive message that he often brings. He always brings something positive. He's a great entertainer. I don't think it's such a bad thing that a father goes off on a son, okay? We don't know what that situation was all about. It's easy to say, oh, he's a gospel singer and he shouldn't be cussing. I mean, come on, man, we're all human. You know, if you actually, I'm not even getting into the religious aspect of all the thing, but in his religion, the Bible, is pretty clear that everybody's a sinner, but anyway, we all, everybody likes to pretend like they're not, but even, you know, anyway. Anyway, I support Kirk Franklin. I just want to put that out there. I support Kirk Franklin. As far as the whole stimulus, where did most of that money go to? If there was enough to give every single American a check for $18,000, and most of us only saw, most of us pretty much saw $3,600, where did most of that money go to? Because we're going to be responsible for that full amount. Anyway, I just want to put that out there. I'm going to go inside Rule King, see if they have any ammo. Yeah. You guys know what that's like. Anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.